Hey everyone, this is me Satya here and I'm doing your second week of November reading start from the 8th through the 14th of November 2020. This is going to be for the sign of Aquarius. Let's see what is coming up for you guys for this week time. I will be adding oracle cards, I will be adding charms as well, so stay tuned. And while I shuffle the cards, let me remind you it's a general reading, it may not resonate with everyone out there, so always pick the messages which are resonating and leave the rest. For personal readings, you can always reach out to me on my email ID in the description box. You can also follow me on Instagram where I do upload daily readings. And let's find out what is heading towards the Aquarians for this week time starting today. Let's begin. What is coming up for you guys? Six of Pentacles. I do see you buying gifts for someone this week. I feel like, you know, you are going to be spending some money to please people around you, to make them happy, to make them smile, which is a good thing. I just see, like, you know, you being kind to people around you. If you are not planning to do so, I would suggest you to do that. Bring some smiles to the people around you, the people that you love, care, maybe friends and family, maybe, you know, siblings, and, you know, maybe nieces and nephews if you have any. So do buy stuff like that to cheer somebody up. I do see that you're doing, I do see you doing that, but if not, then do that. It's going to bring you happiness. It's going to bring you in that positive state of being where you will be attracting more abundance in your life, in different areas of your life as well. For some of you, you know, especially if you are looking forward to have somebody in your life, I feel like, you know, you might meet somebody who is like that, somebody who's very giving, somebody who's very generous. Maybe you're gonna see this person helping people, bringing them smile, and you're gonna fall in love with this person, thinking that, wow, like, you know, what a kind-hearted person this is. So it could be the case for some of you as well. Maybe you're gonna find somebody very attractive, doing that kind of work for people. Maybe, you know, helping them, maybe feeding them, who cannot afford afford good food. Maybe feeding them with good food as well. It can be your energy, it can be the energy of the person that you are dealing with. If this is your energy, maybe there is somebody out there who is going to get attracted to you for doing that. It's like, especially if you're single, you have a strong chance of either meeting somebody like that, or you have a strong chance of attracting somebody doing that. I'm not saying, like, you know, do it to attract somebody in your life. I'm just saying that, you know, if you do that, if you are that kind of a person, somebody is going to find you very attractive doing that, helping people, cheering them out as well. So let's see more cards. Hierophant. Doing this is going to help you a lot. It's like clearing the negative karmic cycles out of your life, helping people, bringing them smile, especially the ones who you would never see smiling otherwise. If nobody helps them, they are always sad or worried or something. Help those kind of people around you. Or if you have kids around you, help them, buy them gifts, buy them toys, whatever it is that you can buy them for, you know, to bring them happiness, to bring them smile, maybe clothes, new clothes for them. Whatever you can do to bring happiness to people's life, it's gonna clear your karmic cycles. It's gonna clear your negativity around you. It's gonna bring you to the point where you have no regrets from the past left or past lives left, and you are, you know, free, setting yourself free from any past blocks as well. So just do that. Let's see more cards here. Justice. For some of you, maybe if you are married or if you are, you know, looking for a divorce or something, in that situation, I feel like, you know, and if you are willing to have the custody of your child or children, I feel like, you know, you will be getting that very well. Because I do see somebody spending some time with kids as well. So maybe it's going to be you who is going to be happy to see them with you, your kids with you. So that could be the case for some of you as well. But I feel like, you know, whatever it is, it's just do something good for someone. It's gonna bring you happiness. Let's see more cards here. Knight of Cups. The Devil. Queen of Wands. And in the deck, we do have Five of Swords. Hmm. If your love life has been stagnant for quite some time, I feel like, you know, you might be attracting somebody who could be either, married and have kids. Like, if he or she is married, that person is not living with their spouse. Maybe they are divorced, or maybe the spouse has been died, in some situations. Maybe they are dead already and they are single. Like, they are taking care of the babies and stuff. That could be the case for some of you as well. But I feel like, if somebody new is entering in your life, be that somebody from the past, somebody new, there is going to be a strong sexual attraction between the two of you. And I don't know why, but I feel like, the love is going to be missing in this connection. If this is somebody new, hold on. It's going to be more of a sexual connection, where it is going to be with, but let's take two more cards from the top of the deck. Queen of Swords, Three of Wands, the Death, King of Wands. I feel like, even if it's a sexual connection, the connection is very very it's more like maybe the person that you are dealing with is like that. As in, like, I'm not saying that they do have sexual relationship with other people. I feel like, this person is very romantic, somebody who needs sex more than, maybe usual men or women. So I feel like, your person is a certain way, and maybe, seeing them so going crazy for you, to feel you, to need you and stuff like that, maybe you're gonna feel like, this person is not the right one. Maybe you are gonna feel like, maybe I need to hold myself back from this person because maybe they are going to be like, using me for the physical needs only. And if that's the case, I feel like, take your time. If you need some time to understand this person, take your time to understand this person and see this connection grow. Do you think if it is like, if it is meant to be, something more than that, then you have a specific mindset around it, like, I'm not gonna do this and that before we commit, before we do things. I feel like, if you put a restriction there, if you tell this person that we cannot have more than this until and unless we get married, this person is going to agree to that. They are not going to demand more than what you are ready to give in this connection. But yes, I do see that this person is going to be very possessive of you. This person is going to be very addictively possessive about you. Like, this person is going to be somebody who's very controlling in bed and otherwise as well. But I do see that, you will be happy with this person. But yes, I feel like, the connection is going to be very, very hot, is what I'm picking up. It's not going to be like, the usual connections. It's going to be more passionate, of more sexually passionate kind of a connection that you're going to be having with this person. But yes, this person is going to be the provider. This person is going to keep you happy for sure. Be that somebody new, be that somebody from the past, be that single person, be that married person, but whoever it is going to bring you good vibe in your life. This person is going to make you feel needed, wanted by this person. But again, before you could have this person enter in your life, just clear your karmic cycles so you don't have any mental blocks around this kind of a relationship as well, and just you allow this person to enter your life with the good stuff to offer. And don't overthink about their intentions in this connection. But yes, if you need time to see where it goes, take your time. There's no issue in that, but don't overthink or think negative around this connection. Let's see what the oracle has to say. What is coming up for you for this week time? Romantic feelings, your feelings are real and worth exploring. I feel like, the connection, like I said, this person needs the romance more than usual, guys or girls. So just be mindful of that. It's not that that's all that they need. This is not going to be the case with this person. But I feel like, if you have doubts and fear, take your time. There's no hurry, or this person is not in hurry at all. Love is all around you. There is love everywhere all the time. Simply acknowledge this as truth. Keep telling yourself that this person loves you and you are being surrounded with lots of love coming from this person. If you have any doubt and fear around this person's intention. So which else? What else? Okay, this one. And then we're gonna take some charms. Let's see. Last oracle card, and then we're gonna take some charms. Let's see what this has to add to the reading. Courage. You are safe. Fear is an illusion. Set strong boundaries. If you need to set boundaries, set the boundaries. This person is going to help you. This person is going to bring you to the comfort zone where you are going to be ready yourself to bring that, boundaries down for this person, put your guards down for this person. But yes, if you are not comfortable, tell this person is not going to force you to do something, or to, they are not going to tell you, okay, fine, if you are not doing this or if you are not having this, then it's over. This person is going to understand you and where your this need to have a slow pace in this connection is coming from. This person is going to understand you so well. So just let them know what do you want. So yeah, let's see what the charms have started the reading. So we do have a K, O, C, L, and S as alphabets. I feel like, there could be kids involved in this situation, be that your kids or their kids. I do see that there would be kids involved in this situation. And either one of you might be having some pets as well, and who love the pets as well. Things gonna change in your love life for sure. That too in a good way. But yes, I do see that, either you or the person, or maybe both of you, are very obsessive kind of a person in when it comes to relationships. So yeah, that's pretty much it coming for you for this week time. If the reading resonated with you, do like, subscribe, and share. If you're willing to get a personal reading, you can always reach out to me for that on my email ID in the description box. Till I do the next reading for you guys, take care. Bye-bye.